The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants what must soon take place. And he made it known by sending his angel to his servant John, who bore witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, even to all that he saw. Blessed is he who reads aloud the words of the prophecy, and blessed are those who keep what is written therein, for the time is at hand.
Hey, yo, Darren! Man, where you going? Why are you slipping off like that?
Man, you know I'm trying to ditch Chip.
Man, why can't you just tell that fool? Man, he can't room with you no more.
Bro, you know how he is, though. Probably run off and do something stupid.
Bro, say no more. Just chill out. Leave everything to me.
All right, man, let's go.
Hey, Chip, hurry up, man. You're about to get left.
Say, Darren!
Man, wait up.
Come on, well, let's go.
Hey, D, wait for Chip. Man, you know this bum can't make it on his own.
So why did you take him home with you then?
Man, why should I take him home with me when he's staying with you? He is still staying with you, right?
I mean, he was, but I ain't got room for him no more.
What you mean, D? I mean, you don't just run out of room overnight.
Nah, man, you see what happened was, my man D got a new roommate.
A new roommate? So, when were you gonna tell me about it?
Hey, I don't wanna put the man business in the streets.
Nah, man. D, you gotta tell me what's going on.
Man, if you put me out, you know I ain't got no place to stay.
Look, Chip, you need to chill out. You can't walk up on this guy.
So why can't he stay with you?
Yeah, man, why not?
Look, y'all know I don't let no throwbacks run with me. I mean, this reject will ruin my image.
We all know you can't stand no more of that.
Look, you want me to get on your case too? Now, both of you, shut up before I crack this bottle over your head.
Wow, man, you must really be mad. Because I ain't never known you to waste good booze before.
Man, you gonna tell me or not?
All right, man, chill. Man, see, I remember that pretty little mama that works behind the cosmetic counter down at the Central Department Store?
Oh, yeah. You mean to tell me that the ice on her finger ain't for real?
It's real, all right, but who's to say the ice can't be broken.
Oh, man, you put me out for some married chick?
Look, Chip, I told you to chill out. Now just shut up already.
As I was saying, I met this party Chris Miller was giving last night. Dog, she fell in love with me on sight.
Man, I don't believe it. Where's her husband, though?
Oh, he's in basic training at Lackland Air Force Base, Texas.
Man, she need to wait for that fool to get his hair cut.
Yeah, but y'all know, after a few dances, man, she was really feeling me, so you know I had her, man.
Man, I'll bet.
Man, go on. This is getting good.
All right, so check this. Now she's going back home and telling her moms that she's going away for a brief vacation while old man's away.
Yeah. Well, a lot of good that's going to do you down here.
So she's going to be staying with me for at least a month.
You getting the works, huh, player? But how much you putting out?
It's not even like that, man. Like I told you, she really feeling me.
Okay. Yeah, right. D, you told me you were broke.
Look, man, it don't matter. What you need to see is that D got a new roommate.
Exactly.
Man, the lady can't afford no publicity.
The lady? Man, don't you see all she is after is your money? And when your money is gone, she'll be gone.
What do you have to offer? Nothing. So as long as I got a few greenbacks, I'm getting a piece of that action.
Exactly, man. Don't you understand? What if my man got sick and died? The whole way to heaven, he be thinking about the time he wasted on some dumb joke. When my man could have had some real happiness.
Man, I'm enjoying life while I can. And right now, enjoying life is having Mrs. Private Nora Stewart for
Man, what can I stay with you until I find another place?
Man, you sure are slow. Did you not hear my man, Nora wants no publicity, none. This is an undercover mission, you know what I'm saying?
And then where am I supposed to stay tonight?
I don't know.
Man, maybe you should try the Hyatt.
There you go.
Or the Plaza.
That's nice. Okay. That's nice.
Or the rescue mission.
Man, be for real.
Man, I'll tell you what. For real. Just take this.
Look, man, are you losing your mind too?
Hey, we can offer the man some consolation. Man, like I was saying, just take this. Man, get wasted. And where you spend the night won't even matter.
Yeah, man. Get wasted. Oh. You a bum for life. Just face it.
Oh, bars. Oh,
man. I'm feeling it. Give me some on top of that beat. Give me a beat. Yeah.
There you go.
Get out there. Yeah. Freestyle. He ain't ready for it. Mic check, mic check.
One, two.
About to spit a few bars.
Man, do what you do.
Look, everybody hate him, but his name ain't Chris.
Okay.
Far from a hater, I can never hate a
bitch. Whoa, chill, man.
Well, you is, though.
I get him.
Bring him back.
Female. Dogs wouldn't give this dude a bone.
Okay.
Just stick to what you're good at.
Yeah.
Drinking all on those dudes. You are nobody, and all you got is us.
Yeah.
So believe me when I tell you, you'll never measure up.
Oh.
You'll never pull a dime, and you'll never make a buck.
Okay.
So get another bottle and slowly pour it up. Yeah.
Let me get it real quick.
Come on.
Yeah. The mic check.
One, two.
You see, I'm finna rip the fool.
Man, do what you do.
Now hold up, wait a minute.
Okay.
Let's give my dude a break.
Okay.
Cause just the other night, man, I seen him on a date. You know the old girl, Brandy with the Coke bottle shape.
Uh-huh.
The brown mocha diva for 1998.
Oh.
You broke and you feel some type of weight. No, no, he's a joke, man, we boo you off the stage. So go on, grab your bottle, grab your pride, move out the way. I'll call my old girl up to get some play.
Hey, okay. let me rip him, man.
Ooh, kill him with it.
All right.
Yeah.
Mic check.
One, two.
I'm finna serve this fool up.
Man, do what you do.
Man, we just out here trying to kick it.
Yeah.
Have a little fun.
Yeah.
With Howard, Mary Jane, maybe smoke a few blunts.
Yeah.
But this dude is on my nerves. I can't let it be last. I got Cali trying to get it for her afternoon to
pass.
I do it in my ride.
Yeah.
Shit, don't kill my vibe.
Okay.
Get in where you fit in, man. Don't ever leave your lane.
Don't
you a bum, get a cup. Maybe then you get a change. Spend a dollar for my phone. Tell your mama I'm the boss.
But go on then. I don't need you,
man. Whatever.
I can take care of myself.
Is she salty or no?
Well, it did leave me some consolation.
While he was seated on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately and said, "Tell us, what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the world?" Jesus answered them, "There will be many false Christs, wars and rumors of wars, famines and earthquakes in place after place. But the exact day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father."
I wish I was dead.
Now, this is 48th Street, our apartment 115. Good Lord. Excuse me, sir. Sir, can you give me some directions?
Man, go away.
Look, I don't mean to trouble you. I just really need some directions.
Look, man, I don't feel like being bothered. Do you mind?
I'm just looking for this address right
here. Man, I said go away.
would you happen to have a phone that I can use? Mine is apparently
dead. Man, do it look like I'd have a phone?
Well, good Lord, somebody had a rough night last night. Look, is there anything that I can do to help?
Look, man, you don't know me and I don't know you. So why are you pushing up on me like that?
Well, I walked over here because I needed help. But then I noticed that I was apparently annoying you. And even more so, I noticed that you needed help. So what's wrong with helping?
What's wrong? Man, people don't do stuff like that.
Ah, that's where you're wrong, son. Some people do. I'm one of them. It's my job to help people.
Man, you need help yourself. What can you do for me?
Well, if you help me find this address, I'll have a place to stay while I live here. And I can help you first by showing you the way to live.
Huh? Man, can't nobody tell me how to live.
Why are you so hung up on my helping you?
Because I don't know you and how you roll. Besides, no one cares what happens to me anyway.
Why do you say that?
If they did, I wouldn't be sleeping in the streets. I'm not a bum. I got class.
No, I wasn't thinking that you were.
Man, I used to be somebody. I had friends, status, and lots of nice things. But then my whole world began to crumble piece by piece. I made one mistake, one very bad mistake that caused a lot of important people some serious trouble. They couldn't forgive me, so here I am, homeless, friendless, and on this endless cycle. So all I can do is die and make everybody happy, or live in this cesspool of guilt and shame for the rest of my life.
Look, I'm still willing to help you. Help rescue you from this cesspool of sin and shame.
Man, don't you understand there's nothing that you or anyone could do to change what has happened?
I'm not trying to change what has happened. I'm trying to change who it has happened to.
So who are you? The great Houdini?
No, but I know somebody greater.
Man, you're talking crazy.
Yeah, well, it has been said that I lost my mind, but no, I'm not crazy.
You lost your mind, but you're not crazy. Then pray tell, what are you?
A preacher.
Man, I knew this was a scam.
No, seriously. I'm Elder Brian Rogers. I'm sent here by God to preach the word. I'm starting a soul-saving mission in this neighborhood.
If you are a preacher, what are you doing in this neighborhood?
Well, I'm here because the hole doesn't need a physician.
The hole? What hole?
What's your name, son?
Last time it mattered was Trent Newsom, but no one calls me that.
Well, what do they call you?
You don't want to know.
Okay, so what do your friends call you?
The ones I had called me Chip.
So do you mind if I call you Chip?
No, go right ahead. No skin off my nose.
So look, Chip, you having a place to stay, right?
Wrong. As long as this good earth is still standing, I will always have a place to lay my head. Like my so-called ex-friends told me, drink a bottle of wine and it ain't hard to find.
You mean the streets?
Well, there's the plaza. Oh, and the Hyatt. And then there's the rescue mission.
Look, Chip, I got an idea. If you help me find this address, and if it's large enough, you are welcome to stay with me until you find a more suitable place.
Man, you saying I should room with a preacher? Now I know you're crazy.
Well, in the meantime, maybe you can help me find this address.
Yeah, that's it right over there.
Oh, no wonder I couldn't find it. The address is worn off. Now, there should be an old store around here somewhere. Would this be it?
Yeah, that's it right over there. So you mean to tell me you're going to stay there all by yourself?
Yeah, my wife passed away some years ago, and well, my kids are all grown now, and I don't have time to get lonely with my work.
Well, it is a big apartment. It has two bedrooms.
Oh, how do you know that?
I had a girlfriend that lived there once.
Oh, okay.
It's a nice 5-room apartment. It has 2 bedrooms. Nice living room. 2 bedrooms. A big spacious bath. 2 bedrooms. A nice sized kitchen.
Two bedrooms. So does this mean that you've decided to accept my offer?
Well, since you're insisting I live with you, and it's better than crashing in the streets.
Come on then, son.
Sick, you talking to me like you
Shut
crazy,
your mouth,
Mike.
Vanessa, my whatever.
Hey, Chip. Oh, who's your friend?
Oh, hi. I'm Elder Brian Rogers. I'm starting a soul-saving mission here.
Shut your mouth and answer my question.
For your information, I charge who I want to charge. I may be working for you, but I have to tell you my personal business.
Everyone you do is my business.
You don't owe me, Mike! Anyway, it costs more than a few pieces of cheap clothes and a Happy Meal. I belong to nobody, and as long as I live, ain't nobody gonna own this. You hear me? Nobody.
So I should have left you with that deadbeat husband of yours and let you both starve to death. You keep messing with me, and I'll make sure no one comes near you for the rest of your life. Now, are you gonna do this my way, the easy way, or my way, the hard way? You're nothing more than a female dog.
I know what you're calling me, but I'm going to fight you like a man.
No! Look, someone has to put a stop to this.
Get off of me.
Look. Hey, yo, look, it's a fight.
Get off of me.
Oh, that's Crystal. Mike. Get him, Mike.
Look, preacher man.
Get
I know you're preaching all, but if you're going to live around, you got to learn to mind world your own business.
World star.
What causes wars and fighting among you?
Yeah.
Is it not world your passions star that rage within your members?
Oh.
You desire but do not have, so you kill. Oh. You covet but do not obtain, so you fight and wage war. You ask but do not receive because you ask wrongly. To spend it on your passion.
Man, what is he doing?
Man, I believe it's one of the disciples.
Man, he sounds like a pain in the
ass. Submit yourselves unto God and resist the devil and he will flee from you. I have read from chapter 6, verses 5.
Will you shut up, please? Please, shut
yeah,
up.
Man. Please. Go preach to some fools who need it.
Hey, man, yes, like sir. That sap over there.
Hey, there you go.
Please listen. I have been sent here by God to preach the word and set the captives free.
What causes fighting among you?
What you say?
Listen, please. Listen, for the time is at hand.
Man, I hate to say this, but you're a pure fool.
Yeah, well, according to the word, a fool is a man that won't seek salvation for his soul.
Ah, yeah, right. Well, you did break up the fight.
This is where I belong. Praise the Lord. You know what? You and I, we're going to make a great team for our Lord.
Man, you are weird.
Yeah. Listen, I'm going to preach there and live here. I can tell it's going to need a lot of work. Come on.
Oh, man, they had a party out here last night.
Oh, it's disgusting.
Man,
hello, Walter, baby. How's that old back doing?
Excuse me? That's Mr. Walter Fitzgerald to you, if you please.
What do you know anyways? Ain't that right, Mr. Walter Fitzgerald?
Oh, Walter. Walter, stop that and listen to me.
What is it, woman? Don't you see I'm busy?
When we're moving out of this neighborhood, we need to take our business someplace else.
Now, you know we can't afford to move. Now, I know business has slowed since they closed traffic at this end of the street. Plus, everything is paid for.
I know that, but this place is ruining my reputation.
Which one?
As a fine Christian woman.
Oh, woman, we've been here for 15 years and hadn't heard you before. Now, you used to be proud of our business and this location.
Well, that was before the Pleasant View Church moved off the corner.
Oh, that's when you became a big shot member of Pleasant View.
Well, yes, I was. But now I've moved my membership to the Belle Queen Church, and all my close friends are there. And this place is putting an ugly scar on my character.
Are you sure it's the place and not you?
And what do you mean by that?
Look, you've been calling yourself a Christian for years. You know what? I don't even think you know what the word Christian means.
I most certainly do, but what do you call yourself?
A sinner.
Amen, amen.
Because I ain't going to be no hypocrite, that's why.
And what are you implying now, may I ask?
Look, I'm just telling you the truth.
Well, I know you're not referring to me.
Look, if the shoe fits, now, I'm a sinner. Gonna stay a sinner, go enjoy being one. But what I'm not gonna do is go around pretending while some phony preacher gyps me out of my money. No, I'm not gonna do that.
Walter, not all preachers are crooks, and you can't go around judging all for the former mistakes your pastor made.
Well, then, All I ask is this. Find me somebody that preaches from the Bible, lives what they preaches, then I might stop my sinning. That's all I ask.
Walter, you know good and well I can't do that. There are no perfect people, no perfect preachers, and we all have to sin every once in a while.
Yeah, right. If that be the case, they might as well burn down all the churches and fire all the preachers because it's all in vain.
Well, they have to make a living.
Not on me, they don't. It's one thing I learned in the Bible is this, that Satan was kicked out of heaven because of sin. And if you're doing the same thing, you're sure not getting in. And if that's what those phony preachers are preaching, they sure ain't getting my money because there ain't no sin getting into heaven.
Well, what about all of the work I do in the church? I serve on the usher board. I do charity work. I sing in the adult choir. Why, just last week, I emceed for Mrs. Murrell's fashion show for the underprivileged children at Water Creek.
So,
I know that the Lord is not going to overlook all of my benevolent service.
Look here, woman, your works are not going to save you. What you need to do is go somewhere and sit down and study your Bible, because none of it's going to get you a seat in heaven anyway.
Well, what do you know, Walter? You don't even go to church.
I can't afford to. It's too expensive.
That's interesting, Walter, because I see you can afford your poker parties and your beer parties, and only God knows what else.
Well, you got that right. I also can afford a new dress every payday, a new hat, new shoes, new bag, all because you won't wear the same outfit.
Well, what's wrong with that? I mean, don't you want me to look fashionable?
Look here, fashionable is one thing, but what you're doing, it's too much. It's an obsession and it's ridiculous. And all you do, you and your friends, is just talk about people who don't meet up to your approval. Look here, honey, I got a revelation for you.
What?
You and your friends are not God's anointed or appointed fashion police.
Oh, you really are feeling your oats today.
Yeah, and another thing, all the meddling, all the lying, all the gossiping, gonna send you straight to hell just as fast as me.
Oh, now wait just a minute. You're going to hell, all right, but without me, because ain't no man that deliberately calls himself a sinner gonna judge my life, my church affairs, or my hereafter.
Oh, whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Hi, Sam.
Here she
Girl,
comes.
Girl, you open yet? Honey, I'm just starving for me some.
Gossip?
What you say, Walter? Is that a new dish?
Oh, no. We serve it quite often here.
Oh, whatever, honey.
Come on up and have a seat, girl.
I thought you'd never ask.
I thought you were dieting.
Oh, I was. Mm-hmm. But my new boyfriend, he wants me to put on a few pounds. So.
A few pounds? Really, Miss? I'm sorry. What will you have, Miss Marshall?
Let me get 3 eggs scrambled. With 3 of those thick slices of bacon y'all got back there. And 3 big old heapings of hash browns. With some wheat toast on the side.
Okay, how many slices?
3, Walter. You know I likes to get a balanced diet.
Well, as long as you pay for it.
Oh, is he mocking me? Oh. He's so nice, isn't he?
Why, yes, he is. You know, I was just sitting here thinking, trying to remember the last time we so as much had a crossword to say to each other.
All right, Hazel. Tell one about your new neighbors.
Oh, my new neighbor? Mm-hmm. I don't know anything. Mm. I haven't seen him. Has he arrived yet?
Yes, he has. Uh-huh. I say he came in early this morning, and he came in fighting.
Fighting?
That's what I said. So you better watch your back.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear's right. They say he started a fight with that Michael Henderson boy.
Uh-huh.
And then Crystal, she gonna jump in and try to help out. Uh-huh. He beat that girl near back to death, honey. Oh, I mean, not that she didn't deserve it, that is.
You know, now that I think about it, I saw that Crystal this morning. And she didn't look too well.
Mm.
Tell me, what does he look like?
Oh, I didn't see him. But I'd imagine he's about 6'4" tall, 300 pounds, big old strapping man. Carries around a big old black suitcase with him.
No, girl.
Oh, yeah.
I bet he carries a gun in it.
You know what? I bet he does.
Oh.
But get this, Hazel. They say Chip Newsom. You know Chip Newsom, right?
Uh-huh.
Chip Newsom jumped in, tried to break it all up. Girl, he slammed that boy to the ground, and he drug him in that apartment over there.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, yeah.
You don't think he's like that?
Well, honey, I don't know nothing about that right there. I'm just telling you what I heard.
Oh, see, I told Walter we need to move out of this neighborhood.
Move? Well, what you gonna do about that, Hazel?
I don't know. Oh, I got it. A petition.
Okay.
A petition is always a good place to start.
Yeah, that sounds good, Hazel, yeah. But what will it say?
Well, how about, oh, never mind. That won't do.
I got it, Hazel. We, the concerned citizens of 48th Street, want to make sure that our businesses and our children's and our homes are protected. So let's get rid of that gangster at 115th on 48th. That'll do the mail.
Well, that sounds pretty good, but...
Thank you, honey, but what?
Well, don't we need to include a reason why we want him out? And don't we need his name?
Well, Hazel, you have good enough reason. You can ask little old Crystal about that. And don't you know his name?
No, don't you?
No, he's your neighbor.
Well, you're the one writing the petition.
But this is your problem. I don't live on this street.
Miss Marshall, how you want your eggs? Soft or hard?
I call myself helping you out, my dear.
Hard.
Well, I didn't ask for your help now, did I?
Well, then why am I wasting my time?
Habit, probably.
Oh, habit. You know what? You can just get used to your new neighbors and your new living arrangements without my assistance.
I guess I can.
You just feeling yourself today, ain't you? All right, then. I tell you what, I gotta go anyway. Got to go see Beverly before she gets off work. Yes, got a little secret to tell her about Janice Wilson.
Oh, what is it, girl?
Oh, no, Miss Hazel, no, you know, I'm not one to gossip, sugar. Can't tell you that. Oh, but I'll see you tonight at church, right? And good luck getting to know your new neighbors.
Where'd she go?
What?
Oh, man, I thought she wanted to put on a few pounds. This happens every morning, wasting food, and I'm getting tired of it. By the way, what were you and Miss Marshall talking about? Mrs. Walker's new weave or something?
No, Walter, our new neighbor. He's a professional killer. He beat up Mike and Crystal, then he kidnapped poor Chip Newsom, and he carries a big black briefcase with a gun in it. Walter, I want to move.
Look here, you know what? You know, this is too much. Anything I do for you. First, it's the neighborhood. Now this manufactured killer that Miss Marshall just invented. And when did Chip become poor little Chip? Now I told you we can't afford to move, so enough of this needless drama.
Well, if that's the way you feel about it, Walter, don't come running to me the next time your back goes out.
That's woman, boy. Hey, Brady, what's up, man?
Hey, it's my main man, Walter. How you doing, son? What's going on?
Oh, man, this woman of mine getting on my nerves. What's going on? You opening up 3 hours early, aren't you?
Yeah. Some of the boys said they would make a few runs for me this afternoon.
Man, why you keep involving them boys in this? Brady, you know they get them in some trouble.
Why? Because I'm too old and they don't mind.
But it's illegal.
And they still don't mind. Besides, I paid them real good.
You and them boys will end up in jail.
We ain't got caught yet. Besides, I got to make a living.
Boy, I tell you, times sure have changed.
Yeah, I know it's risky business, but it's all about the business I get now.
I guess you know what you're doing, but aren't you afraid you might end up in prison?
Yes. But at least if I get caught, I won't have to worry about my retirement plan. Know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well, you got a point there. You're right about that, man. Man, you know what? You're crazy, Brady.
Yeah,
crazy.
I know. Besides, Jeff said he wanted to take it over one day anyway.
Okay, cool. That'll work.
Right, come on. Have a drink with your boy.
Man, I need one. Whew.
Give me some service here, please. Waiter, cook, dishwasher, anybody. Service.
Yes, sir. Oh, may I help you? Chip, if you don't get your filthy self up from my table. Now, you know I don't go serving every Tom, Dick, and Harry that walks in here off the street looking for a free meal.
I beg your pardon, madam. I am financially able to pay for my order.
Well, you still can't eat here. Besides, what will you eat out of?
What will I eat out of?
Your dishes. When do people have to supply their own plates and forks to y'all this nasty restaurant?
Now, you don't think I'm going to serve him out of the same dishes my regular customers use, do you? Or you either, for that matter.
You think I got a social disease or something?
Honey, I don't doubt that. I hear about the things you do.
Crystal?
Nasty.
What?
Have you been a naughty girl?
Maybe. But the owner of this establishment loves the things I do.
And that's another thing. I am sick and tired of the insulting accusations you keep making about my husband.
Who's making accusations, Hazel?
You are, and I know it. I mean, Walter's no Christian or anything. But my husband wouldn't stoop so low. Honey, he considered a dog first.
Honey, you don't stay home long enough to know what your man would do. You best watch your step, because this bad dog will bite.
Hey, look. I ain't butting into nothing, but I do know that when a man is harder for real, good, loving, he will do almost anything to get it.
Yes, and deprived, hard-up husbands are my specialty.
Get off my porch.
Do you wonder why your husband let you do all that charity work you do?
Honey, because unlike you, he knows I'm a dedicated Christian woman.
Why, yes. While you're devoting all your time to others, someone has to stay home and take care of your neglected charity work.
Get off my property, both of you.
Down, girl. Down. 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 You better watch your mouth, lady. She hasn't been vaccinated yet.
Yes.
Now, would you please take our order?
Yes, I have a very busy schedule. Charity work.
Walter! Walter, get out here!
Call him.
Oh, man, can a man enjoy his drink? What you want, woman? What's bothering you?
You get...
Good morning, everyone.
Oh. I preach. Come on up and take a seat.
Why, yes, sir, preacher man. You can have my chair.
Oh, no, I wouldn't dare take a lady's chair.
Oh. That's all right. Chair, please.
All right. Hold my drink. Really?
I'm so sorry that I don't have more seating outside. Perhaps you'd like to come inside.
No,
it's much nicer.
No, this is fine. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh.
Have you ordered yet, Chip?
No.
Excuse me? You know him?
Oh, yeah. Chip's my roommate.
Does that surprise you?
Well, don't you think you should get to know people a little better before you associate with them?
Oh, I know all I need to know about Chip. Chip was a man in trouble, and I was in the position to help him.
You know you helped me out of a tight spot this morning as well.
Oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Yeah. Yeah, you started reading from that black book, the fighting stopped, crowd broke up, and I got a place to sleep.
Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Wait, you mean to tell me you are this so-called gangster?
Well, that Miss Marshall, she really can't exaggerate, but boy, was she way off this time.
Right, you think? Look, Reverend, let me explain something to you.
Hold on, you told me you were a preacher.
Oh, I am. My title was elder. I'm Elder Brian Rogers.
Oh, nice to meet you, Elder Rogers.
Pleasure to meet all of you as well.
Have you ordered breakfast yet?
Oh, there you go. Cheesing up to some old preacher.
Well, I'm only trying to be polite.
Hazel, I didn't know you had a polite bone in your body.
Now, you wait just a minute, you floozy. What makes you think that...
Go on, Hazel, dear. Your true self is coming through.
My true self?
You know what? I don't have to take this. I'm out, Chip. And good day, Reverend. Thanks for the help.
Oh, no problem.
Reverend. Yes. I am so sorry for the way I have acted. Please forgive me. You know, sometimes people just piss us, upset us a little.
Yes, I do understand. That's why the word teaches us to be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to wrath.
Okay.
May I order now, please? I'm starving.
Sure, Chip. Okay.
Honey, I'm going over to Brady to see if he need any help. Excuse me, Rep.
But Walter, we have guests.
He probably phoned it too.
Hey, Chip, I'm going to check out the store. I could use your help if you want to come.
I'll do whatever you ask. Just let me get something to eat first.
Oh, yeah, sure. Take your time.
Bye-bye.
Oh, see ya.
It's so nice meeting you.
You as well.
Hey. May I order now, please?
Oh. There you go. What will you have, Chip?
The hot lunch plate special and a large orange soda.
We're out of the hot plate lunch special.
Okay, give me 2 cheeseburgers then.
The hamburger didn't thaw out last night.
Okay, how about spaghetti and meat sauce?
Spaghetti and meat sauce. We sold out of that last night.
Man, then give me whatever you have then.
Oh, okay. I got something for you. Oh, you're gonna like this. I'll sell this to you for half off. How's that?
That's good.
Here you go.
This stuff is ice cold.
That's our cold breakfast plate.
Man, never mind. I'll take my business someplace else.
Thank you. I thought you'd never get the message.
So, Chip, you found a place yet?
Don't let that worry you. I'm doing just fine.
I ain't worried.
Hey, look, man. We about to make a drop. You with us or not?
I don't think so. Who's the girl?
Oh, this is my cousin Nora from down south.
How you doing?
Where you from, Mrs. Nora?
What did he just call me?
Oh, nothing, babe. You know, he don't know nothing.
Look, you better watch your jokes, man, because they ain't funny.
Yeah, speaking of jokes, man, you heard the one about the prophet's wife who's in town?
Are you sure he don't know nothing?
Yeah, it's just a coincidence.
Hey, Will, you packing heat?
Hey, man, I always do when we make a drop. Yeah.
Man, you boys expecting some trouble?
Nah, but we're going to eliminate any trouble before we get there.
Come on, guys. Let's not start any trouble, please.
Yeah, you don't want this undercover mission to go public now, do you?
You know what?
Man, let's go see if the old man got the stuff ready.
All right, let's go. Yeah, you know, because we about to get paid.
That's right.
You wouldn't know nothing about that, you and your broke self.
Darren. You going to buy me that drink you promised?
Of course. Anything for my baby. My cousin. Yeah, my cousin. Yeah.
Cousin.
Excuse me, young man. Would you like to earn some extra money?
Sure, man. What you selling?
Oh, I'm not selling anything. I just need some help fixing up this old store. I'm starting a mission here.
You mean a church?
Yeah, that's right.
Nah,
dude, I ain't been to church since my mom's got married.
Man, you don't need that kind of help, preacher, man.
Our kind of help? We got money and mo, cuz. So why don't you get this fool to help you out, unless he done acquired a fortune overnight or something?
Nope.
Our kind of help.
Darren, I thought you was going to buy me a drink or something.
I am. Chill.
You going to buy that child a drink?
Just a soda?
I don't want no soft drink.
Well, you should have been woke.
Hey, look, I could really use your help.
Look, old man, we got some real business to take care of, and we ain't got the time. You know, time is money, and we ain't about to spend no time on you.
Come on, man, let's go. Hey, but hold up a sec, because me and Jeff kind of been meaning to talk to you about something.
Mm. What's good?
Actually, bro, it's about sharing the goods.
Darren, let's go. I'm getting bored.
Oh,
what?
We can sure enough take care of that.
Yeah.
You're too young, bro. You're too young, man.
Yeah.
Gotta step your game up.
Oh, yes.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah.
What's going on?
Yeah. I'm sorry, Reverend, but that's just the way things are around here.
It's not just here, son. these people or these streets. It's everywhere. That's why I've been commissioned by God to be here and serve. You know, he's so full of mercy. He gives us ample time to find truth. But what do? We harden our hearts and continue in our sins. It's a privilege to be saved, you know.
Saved? Saved from what?
Your sins. Don't you know of any saved people?
I'm afraid not.
Yeah, well, it's a blessing to be saved. God actually desires for all of us to be saved.
Are you saved?
Oh, with all my heart. My sins are washed away. I'm sanctified holy and baptized of the water and the Holy Spirit.
Well, there are some religious folk, but none of that you're talking about.
Yeah, well, if they were true Christians, God would be number one, and you would know it.
Yeah, all the ones I know are full of pride, stuck on themselves. I don't care that much for them.
Listen, real saints of God don't act like that. Listen, when you're saved, the joy of the Lord fills your heart. And it's that joy that becomes your strength. Listen, James 4:6 says that God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. Woo! One day, sooner than you think, all of this is going to come to an end.
All of what?
The world as we know it. And only the saints of God will be saved.
Man, I thought the saints were dead or in heaven somewhere.
No, a saint is anyone who dedicates his life to the will of God and is led by the Holy Spirit. You know, you too could be a saint.
I don't like getting into stuff I don't know nothing about.
Yeah, well, I'm praying. I'm praying that you will come to know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You, your friends, and as many as the Lord will call.
Well, I don't understand a lot about all of this, but I do feel different since I met you.
Amen.
Kind of scary, like.
Now, that's a good sign. To fear God is the beginning of wisdom. Now, come on, I can use your help in the store.
Look here, fellas. I want you guys to be careful, okay, with that stuff.
Man, we know what we're doing.
Yeah. Look, I just don't want my old friend to get in any kind of trouble, that's all.
Look, man, I'm going to tell you right now. What? If I'm going down, I'm going to take that bum with me.
Yeah, what's the matter, old man? Don't you trust us?
Look, I just want you guys to be careful, that's all.
Oh, we know what we're doing, old man.
Look, man, I can handle my business now. Look.
That stop.
Walter! Walter, what are you doing?
Get your good.
Walter!
Walter. I can take care of myself.
You're drunk.
I can take care of myself.
Okay. Walter, get up out of that street before someone sees us.
Just leave me alone, you old bat. Always cheesing up to some old preacher.
You want me to handle him for you? I know him best when he's like this.
Shh, Crystal, baby. She might hear us.
There's a party going on right upstairs.
Just get him inside for me.
Okay.
I cannot be seen with him in that condition.
Go in the house.
Your place of mind, Big Daddy.
You know, Crystal, I've been having some back pains. Can you help me out with that?
I guess my place.
Okay. You know what? Also, my wife, she goes to church all the time. She don't miss me. She never misses me.
Yes, charity work. Always charity work.
I'm going to get a broom. Send a revival. Send a revival. Hey, hallelujah, that's it. A revival. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, that's what we're going to do. Hey, Chip. Chip, come on out here, son. Hallelujah, a revival. Woo.
Hey, what's the excitement for, Red?
Hey, listen, we are going to have a big soul-saving revival. Woo. And I'm going to bring in all the saints from my hometown. Hallelujah.
Okay.
And as long as the Lord allows, we're going to preach and teach the word of God.
Yes. What am I getting so excited for?
It's Jesus, boy. It's Jesus. Come on now. Send a revival. Send a revival.
Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name, and in thy name cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works? And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work in iniquity.
Oh, no, no, no. Don't try to move that by yourself. That's heavy. Let me see if I can get us some help. Oh, praise the Lord. Yes, Mr. Newsom, we need your help. That old piano is heavier than we thought.
Sure, what do you want it?
We want it as close to the door as possible, because we want the music as loud as it can get.
Y'all plan on having a swinging time, huh?
We always have a good time in the Lord. But aren't you staying for the services?
Not if I can help it.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm splitting as soon as I finish my job.
Pastor Brian would be so hurt if he knew that you were not going to stay for the services.
I know. That's why I'm trying to finish my job before he gets dressed.
So, what do you have to do that is so important?
I don't think that's any of your business.
You know you're right. But young man, there is nothing that is more important than serving the Lord.
Look, ma'am, I don't want to be rude or anything. I don't want to show any disrespect to Elder Brian or to God, but I've been listening to Elder Brian for the last 4 weeks, and I don't want to hear anymore.
So what are you afraid of?
Afraid of? Man, I ain't scared of nothing. I'm just tired of that preacher being on my back. Repent, repent, repent. That is all he talks about.
Because he loves you. And anyone who loves God would do the same. You know, it's true. God is a good God. But young man, don't you get it twisted. Because God is also a God of wrath.
I've heard it. I've heard it. Now lay off me, will you?
All right. But know this. Once you've heard the word of God, the word will always be with you. And either you're going to reject it completely or you're going to receive it completely. And until you do, your conscience will not let you rest. And if God is striving to be with you, and well, you constantly
Where
reject
Where did you
him,
want the piano, ma'am?
Okay, I'll show you. Lord, save his soul. Mothers, pray with me that the Lord will save him. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Walter. Walter, I think this is so ridiculous.
Oh, you would, wouldn't you? Now, for the last time, shut up. We're staying.
But Walter, I've heard about these indignant, sanctified church folk. People of culture don't attend these barbaric church services.
Now, where did you hear that?
From Belle Queen. When we received the invitation to this revival, Belle we Queen. Disregarded it immediately.
So that makes it wrong to come?
Of course. If it's not worth discussing, it's not worth attending.
Oh, boy. You know, I don't know. We might be in the wrong place.
Why do you say that, Walter?
Look at that woman. She's dressed for a funeral.
Who is that?
I don't know.
You know, I've seen that dress and those shoes somewhere before.
Man. I wonder where everybody is.
I don't know, Walter, but I wish I could leave before they all get here.
Hey, Brady. Can't open up tonight.
Why not?
Might as well come over here and have a seat.
All right. So, has the party started yet?
What party, Brady?
The boys told me they were supposed to be a real shindig with dancing and singing and everything.
No, not a shindig, a revival.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
No, not that kind of revival. This is church service. They're having church out here because it's too hot in the church.
Church?
Yep.
In the streets? Oh, God, these new preachers try to get away with murder.
Yeah, they
tell what are you it. Talking about, Brady?
Ain't no one gonna buy beer with church going on right at my doorstep.
Well, that's why you need to come on over here, have a seat, and enjoy yourself.
Man, are you serious?
No.
Reverend, Attorney Peeler, Sister Sweeney, what are you all doing here?
Well, what are you doing here?
Well, I thought I could start a petition to get this man kicked out of town.
Oh, is that right? Well, now, we came to see what this Elder Rogers fella has to tell us about the Bible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we thought if we could embarrass him publicly, he will cease all this nonsense about holy living.
Everybody knows it's not logical.
Yes, God is a God of love. Why, he'll forgive everybody. We'll just have to set him straight on that tonight.
Amen.
Forgive everybody.
Honey, who is this preacher?
Why, that's the right J.B. Henderson. A Bell Queen Church, ABMDIVDD and LLD.
ABCDEFG HIJKLMNOP.
Sticks out all over. Hey, Will, man, that was a good run today.
Yeah.
Hey, man, what?
Yeah.
Look at all this cash, fool.
Yeah.
Hey, I forgot the preachers have a church tonight.
Hey, man, forget all that. You know we finna have our own church, too.
Man, what? Yeah.
Sorry, fellas. Bar's closed tonight.
What?
Isn't that right, old man?
Dude.
Right. Tonight we're having church services to lift our spirits.
Hey, man, that ain't the spirit that I'm trying to get lifted.
Man, nah, what? But you know, they looking kind of dead.
For real,
though. I'm used to seeing that stuff on TV where, the preacher has to get in like this and has to get some of that bark and some of that shout.
Man.
And speak, what's that language they speak in?
Tongues.
Yeah, that's the one.
They speak in tongues.
Walter, how do you know so much?
Well, believe it or not, I used to be saved once. And I grew up in a church like this.
Say what?
Yep.
You? Well, what happened?
Well, I was young and my mother died, and I just thought I could do whatever I wanted to do. I tried other denominations, and I just got further and further away from the truth. So, here I am.
That's cool and all, but is the reverend taking up offering? Because my money's spent, dog.
Look, if they do, they sure ain't getting no money out of me.
Yeah, I know that's right.
Hey, wait a minute. Did you fellas find a wallet about 4 weeks ago?
No, sir. Nah, Eddie, where's Nora at?
Don't worry about it.
Chip,
man, where are you going?
Uh-oh.
Man, what are you all doing here?
Man, we just come to church, to serve your Lord. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Hey, you found work yet?
What is it to you?
Ooh.
Now, won't you guys be nice and leave? Elder Brian's been planning this revival for a while now. He'll need you guys to mess it up.
Hey, man, if I can remember correctly, he invited me personally.
Yeah.
Man, so I'm staying.
And if he's staying, so am I.
Man, you may as well stick around and play bodyguard or usher or whatever you are now. Who knows? Holy Spirit might get so high, I might just dance a hole right through your chest.
Chip, can you tell the choir it's time?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Miss Marshall, so glad that you could make it. Praise the Lord. Reverend. Hopefully we'll get a chance to work together sometime.
Yes, but we want to talk to you now about your ministry.
Well, hopefully it can wait till after service. Crystal, listen, the Lord wants to bless you and your husband, but you got to let him.
Elder Brian.
Yes.
They're ready.
Okay, thank you. Hey, Chip. You let the Lord use you.
Glory to God. Glory.
Mother Franklin, I've got a testimony.
Oh,
Jesus. I tried, Jesus.
I tried.
God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and bow your heads in prayer with me, please. Almighty and glorious Heavenly Father, we are assembled here tonight to witness the power and everlasting glory of your word. Let your Holy Spirit touch hearts, deepen our wisdom, and increase our understanding. Let your word go forth tonight and give strength and encourage the saints to continue in this fight. But most of all, Lord, let your word go forth and convict lost souls and guide them to salvation. This we ask in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Everybody said amen.
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 And amen.
Amen. Amen.
My scripture for tonight is taken from 1 John, 2nd chapter, verses 15 through 17. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For if any man loves the world, then the love of the Father is not in him.
Amen.
For all that is in the world, the lust of the eyes and in the pride of life, is not of the Father, but of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of the Father shall abide forever.
Amen.
Amen. The choir is coming with another selection.
Of themselves.
That's the sign of the time.
Steve and opposed to the truth.
That's the sign of the time.
Don't let that day catch you stuck in your ways. Get your house in order. We're soon to return.
Walter, now you know that's not proper.
Oh, shut up.
Oh. Amen.
Somebody give the Lord a good God bless you. First, giving honor to God. Yes. This lovely choir. Yes. All the mothers that made it in, God bless you. All the friends and the people from Born Again Church that made it here from Nashville, Tennessee, God bless you. I'm thankful for even those who don't like me so much. Amen. I'm thankful for all of you. But you know, I'm thankful that he saved me, sanctified me, and filled me with his Holy Spirit.
Hey, y'all, man, that choir can blow, man. Let's get the choir back out. Let's have more singing.
Sit up, man. What
you
doing, Chip?
Man, sit Chip. Down, Chip.
Chip. Oh. Check yourself. Yeah. Check yourself.
Man, sit down.
Sit down. You can blast it up in here.
Sit down. The Lord's on your side, son.
Oh.
It's all right.
Low show.
The Lord is on
sit
your
down.
Side.
Oh. Sit back down.
Walter, this would never happen at Bell Queen.
Of course not. You got to pass security to get in your church.
Oh, man, what y'all looking at?
Man.
Tonight, I want to preach from the subject, the rapture, and what it will take to be a part of it. No sin shall enter into the kingdom of God. Now, most of you here who believe in God would say, I know that. But what troubles me is if you know it, what excuses do you have to continue in sin? Why do I say that? Well, when you think of sin, what comes to your mind? Is it that old drunk on the street? Or perhaps the man that killed his wife and his children? Or perhaps the young girl that shoplifts for a living. Well, you're right. These are sinners. Oh, but tonight I want to talk to all sinners. The educated ones, the professional ones, the hypocritical ones. Who are these people and how do I know that they exist? Romans 1, 28 to 31, and 1 Corinthians 6, 9, and 10 gives us some characteristics of the sinner. Listen and see if you qualify. Is there any adulterers, whoremongers, homosexuals, thieves, drunkards, or fornicators among you? Now, this is what we call big sins. And most morally good people don't do them. Uh-huh. But the word continues. Yeah. Are there any liars? Yeah. See, the Bible says, the Bible says liars will have their place in the lake, which is called the second death. Is there unrighteousness, maliciousness, covetousness, wickedness, envy, deceit, pride, boasters, or inventors of evil things among you? If so, you too are qualified victims of God's angry wrath. And if you do these things, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. But what about the good that I've done? Surely God's not going to overlook that. Well, I'm here to tell you tonight that it's nice to be good. But are you saved from your sins? Listen, you can't outweigh the bad that you've done by simply doing good. You have to repent of your sins and present yourself holy unto the will of God. Say amen, somebody. Woo, put them hands together. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody, put them hands together. You love Jesus tonight? Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. Let's look back at the Bible. Let's see how God deals with sin as opposed to the righteous. God did not spare the angels who sinned, for he cast them into hell where they are chained in darkness, awaiting judgment day. God did not spare the ancient world of godless men, for the only one he saved was Noah, who preached righteousness, and seven other people. God condemned Sodom and Gomorrah, destroying them with fire, but rescued Lot, a righteous man who was troubled by the immoral conduct of lawless men. So, do you think that God is going to spare you if you're guilty of the same sin? Which are you, saved or lost? Because there is no in between. Because what he said, if you are lukewarm, he'll do what? Spew you out of his mouth. Come on now. Now, I hear you saying. I hear you. So suppose this preacher man is right. Suppose I do have to live holy in order to be saved. Well, I'm not ready yet. When I'm older, maybe. I got to live it up first. Well, suppose you die while you're living it up. Then hell will be your eternal home. Listen, you don't have time to live it up. God is calling for holiness now while you still have a chance. Come on, Jesus. Now, for some of you, tonight might be your last chance. See, we know not where death is, and we know not when Jesus Christ will return. 2 Peter 3:10 says, but the day of the Lord is like a thief in the night. Now think about it. When a thief comes to rob you, he doesn't call you up, inform you that he's coming. No, he comes when you least expect him to, always catching us unaware. And so it will be when the Lord Jesus Christ comes back for his church without spot or wrinkle. Will you be ready to go back with him? Oh, I often think about that day. That glorious day when all God's children's worries will be over. When he comes to take us back before his angry wrath befalls the earth. The day of the rapture. What will you be doing? How will it find you? The rapture. Oh, on that day, he himself will descend from heaven with the cry of command and with the call of the archangel and with the sound of the trumpet. Now listen, the sinners won't hear this sound, for they'll continue in their sins. Oh, but the dead in Christ shall arise first. Then we who remain will be caught up, caught up, caught up to meet him in the air. Come on to put them hands together. Hallelujah. And forever we will be with the Lord. Hallelujah. But what of those who refuse to do God's will? Listen, listen, listen. God has had mercy long enough. He sent preachers to preach the mysteries of the gospel. But you refuse to listen. What about those who are left? Who are not caught up to meet him? Revelation 6. 12 and 16 gives us just one of those terrible ordeals that will happen on that day. And he opened up the sixth seal. And I looked. And behold, there was a great earthquake. And the sun became black as sackcloth. And the moon became as blood. And the stars fell to the earth as the fig tree sheds its winter fruits when shaken by a gale. And the sky vanished, rolled up like a scroll. And every mountain and every island was removed from its place. And then all the kings of the earth and all the great men and all the generals, everyone, slave and free, ran into the caves and hid among the mountains and the rocks and cried out to the mountains and the rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of he that sitteth on the throne. Fall on us and hide us from the Lamb, from the wrath of the Lamb. Which shall your soul experience? Everlasting life or eternal death? The time is now, people. God is getting tired of man's sinful nature. Time is running out. How do I know that time is running out? Sister, will you get for me 2 Timothy 3, 1 through 5? Oh, saints, just pray in your spirit.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, God.
But understand this.
Uh-huh.
That in the last days.
Yes.
There will come times of stress.
Times of stress. Listen, there will be some tough times in the last days. Today, every time you turn around, there's something else going on. Planes disappearing out the sky. Every way you turn around, there's another terrorist attack. Times of stress. Come on, read.
For men will be lovers of self, lovers of money.
Selfish people. Listen, men will do whatever they want to get what they want. Regardless of who they hurt or what it took to get there. Lovers of money. Lie for it. Cheat for it. Even kill for it. Come on, read.
Proud. Arrogant.
Yes.
Abusive.
Yes.
Disobedient to parents.
Disobedient to parents. Listen, when in the history of man has children had so much that now they tell mom and dad what to do. And they do whatever they want to do. Come on, somebody, regardless of what they're told. Read.
Ungrateful. Unholy.
Yes.
Implacable. Slanderous. Profligate.
Profligate. Wasteful people. Extravagantly reckless. Spending money on any and every little thing because it's your money to spend. Come on now, read.
Fierce haters of good.
Stop right there. Haters of good. You hate good because you prefer to do wrong. You hate good because you enjoy living in sin. You hate good because doing good might mean being left out of the crowd. I can't go to church today. Y'all know the game is on. I would have gone on Friday night. But y'all know that my club had a dance. I would have gone last week. But, you know, I stayed out so late Saturday night. I just couldn't get up. Come on now, read.
Holding the form of religion, but denying the power of it.
Listen. Jesus. You go to church, but you could care less what the preacher says.
Bless the Lord.
Denying the power of the Holy Spirit. Denying the power of that which makes us clean. Denying the power of that that's going to keep us until Jesus comes back. Oh, somebody needs that power. Somebody's longing for that power. Oh, do you want that power? Do you need that power? Listen, there's somebody in here tonight that you want to be washed clean of your transgressions. You want to be washed clean from the sin in your life.
Bless the Lord.
Do you feel the Spirit of God calling at your heart? Do you feel it? He's calling for you, and tonight you have the opportunity to say yes. While the Spirit of God is moving, and while the choir is singing, I want you to come and make your humble confessions known before Jesus. Let the whole world know that you want to live for Jesus. Will you come? Hallelujah. Will you come? There's room at the cross for you.
There is room at the cross for you.
Oh, come on, will you come?
Oh, Lord, I'm sorry. Make me clean.
Well, I hope she know that is not going to help her thinking so.
Man, what you doing, Chip?
Where you going? Sit down, Chip. Church ain't over.
I want to be saved. Lord, help me.
Man. Chip ugly, bro.
Chip ugly.
Walter. Walter. Chip too? Walter, let's get out of here. This is catching on. Let's go, Walter. I'll get my bag. Woo, let's go. Ooh. Oh. Oh. Oh, my. Woo.
Oh!
Oh.
See that coming.
Got oh, it. What will man, people man. Say?
Oh, right there. Come on, let's go.
Oh, the Spirit of God is really moving tonight. Listen, if you want to be saved, all you have to do is be godly sorry for the wrong that you've done. Will you come? Hallelujah. God, in the name of Jesus.
That's it, Reverend. That is it. Now, we can't stand for any of this anymore. What are you going to do about it?
You know what? I agree with Miss Marshall. Are you going to do anything about this outrage?
I certainly will. But we must act like civilized people. Tell you what we'll do. We'll call a board meeting to discuss a possible solution to this matter.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. Come on, sugar, let's go. Honey, you don't want none of that. Let's go now.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that makes me white.
I really hate to tell Hazel this, but we just can't stand for it anymore.
Look, you have nothing to worry about. We are doing this in the best interest of Belle Queen, okay?
Yes, I suppose you're right.
All right.
Will there be anything else, ladies?
No, thank you.
Excuse me, boy. Come back here, please. Would you please tell Miss Hazel I said to hurry up? We don't have all day.
Yes, ma'am. Out here.
I really hope she takes this like the lady that I know she is.
Don't worry about it. Just let me do all the talking.
Okay.
Good morning, ladies. Well, praise the Lord anyhow.
They say he has prayer every afternoon around this time.
If he is so saved, I don't see why he has to pray so much.
That's what I'm saying. I mean.
Hello, ladies. Sorry I kept you waiting.
That's all right, sugar. We knew you were probably busy.
Well, Chip said you wanted to see me, so what's on your mind?
Oh, yes, Chip. Now, when did he start working here?
Walter. Walter hired him about 2 weeks ago. I mean, one shouting lunatic on my hand is enough, but now I've got two.
Well, how do you put up with it?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, hello, ladies.
Hi, Walter.
Honey, we'll be back in a minute, okay?
Okay.
They go to prayer every day around this time. But it does give me somewhat of a break.
I see.
Yes, well, that's what we wanted to talk about. See, last night at the board meeting...
Oh, wait a minute. Board meeting? I didn't know anything about a board meeting.
We know you didn't know, Hazel. Now be quiet and let her finish. Go ahead, Miss Sweeney.
As I was saying, last night at the board meeting, the question was raised about the damaging influence your husband has had on our church.
My husband? Well, Walter's not even a member of Belle Queen.
We know he's not a member, Hazel, but you are. Now, there's really no easy way to put this, but either your husband stops that nonsense with that church over there, or you're just going to have to go.
Now, wait just a minute. You can't go putting me out of the Belle Queen, not after all the work I've done for the church.
Now, Hazel, we thought we could come over here and talk to you like about this situation like sensible adult Christian women.
Now, you know your husband is insane, and insanity comes from the devil.
That's right.
And if it got in him, it could possibly get in you, too.
And we can't have none of that mess at Belle Queen.
That's right.
Now, wait a minute, ladies. Before you go and do anything rash, I have a suggestion. Now, Walter's not the problem here, and putting me out of Belle Queen, that's not going to solve anything either. Our problem is that Elder Brian Rogers, if you want to get to the root of the problem, that is.
Hello, ladies. I'm late for prayer.
You see that? Why, he's no preacher. He's some kind of voodoo practitioner. Why, he's cast a spell on all of them. I mean, how else can you account for Chip and Crystal's sudden change of life?
Well, let's not forget your husband. He's changed too, you know.
You know what I think? I think before we pursue this mission any further, Miss Sweeney, we might need to run all this by the chairman of the board.
Yes.
Well, I suppose it wouldn't hurt anything. Well, all right, we'll go have this talk. Mm-hmm. But still, it may not change a thing.
Yeah.
Shall we go?
We're going to go. But listen, Hazel, it should take us just a few minutes to go over your situation, and we'll get back with you immediately with the results, okay? Come on, Miss Sweeney. Oh, my Lord, look at this right here.
What you looking at, man?
That's that Mary Gale.
Slanderous profligates they were talking about at church.
Oh, I wasn't invited there.
My bad. Hey, Miss Fitzgerald.
Oh, Darren. You never did introduce me to your cousin.
Oh, yes, this is my cousin, Nora Stewart from Ohio.
Mm-hmm. How do you do, ma'am?
Fine, and you?
Oh, I'm just fine. Let's
go. Darren, I spoke with your mother last week, and she didn't mention anything about relatives visiting from out of town.
You see, she's been busy at work. They've been staying at my place, and she probably forgot to tell you, so, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Let's go.
Uh-huh. Well, Darren, I guess I'll see y'all here. I'll call your mother and invite your relatives over.
That's not a good idea because they're leaving tomorrow, you know, jetting out. Mm-hmm.
So, yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, perhaps another time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep, another time.
We'll see you then.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I smell something burning. Might want to check on it.
Uh-huh. Nobody likes jawbreaker biscuits. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Darren, what is wrong with you? You are always running off at your mouth at something. I mean, if my husband were to find out about... What?
No one's going to find out anything. Chill, man. Let's go get this drink. Homies!
I know one thing. You better buy my drink this time.
Okay. Walter, you about to buy my beer today.
Say, man. I don't like this neighborhood too much.
Man, why?
Haven't you heard? It's voodoo.
Man, you mean to tell me that a cool dude like you believes in stuff like that?
Sure I do. Look at Crystal. She was the best girl I had. She loved the work, and I know it. Then, all of a sudden, zap! Converted. Man, she won't even talk anymore. She scares me.
She scares you? How?
Well, one time, I asked her to come do some work for me. She was handling my best customers. Do you know what she said to me?
Nah, man, what'd she say?
She said, sex is for married people. And them alone, one man to one woman, and one woman to one man. Everything else is sin, and we are going to burn in hell if we have sex outside of marriage.
But what if we don't get married?
Tough!
Yeah, it is. See, because I can't help it. You know, I just got too
tough. Well, what about my case? I mean, this is my work. My life. I don't know how to do anything else. And if there is a God, I don't think he wants me to starve to death.
I guess you're right.
Anyways... Do you remember when the preacher man was talking about the rapture?
Sorta.
Not really.
Did he really mean that these holy folk are gonna rise up and vanish from their graves? And what about this Jesus dude?
Is he really going to fly from heaven down on the cloud to take them back up to heaven with him?
Man, you don't have any common sense at all. Because people been walking around talking about the end of the world for centuries. And ain't nothing happened yet. Ain't going to happen.
I know. But that's why I think it's coming pretty soon.
And another thing. All the logic in the world will tell you that man can't fly. Look, them preachers just tell you stuff like that to scare you into joining their church. Man, don't fall for that. Stupid.
I guess you're right.
Of course I'm right. Now look, man, stop worrying and let's get this drink. You need a drink. Heck, I need a drink. Time to turn up. Yeah.
I do feel heavy inside and weighed down. I mean, bro, don't you?
Sure, maybe heavy enough not to fly. Now just shut up, man.
Say, man, I ain't got time for no games. Y'all seen Darren and Nor?
Nah, man, why?
Man, the private's in town.
Does he know about?
Yes.
Man, how did he find out?
Man, I don't even know. But it couldn't have been but one person.
Who?
Man, it's gotta be that fool Chip. Man, ever since he got, man, what is it that he is now?
Saved.
Saved, man. Ever since that fool got saved, man, he don't act the way we act no more.
So what you gonna do about it?
Man, I got to find Darren Nor before the private does. Man, and we gonna take care of Chip.
Much spilled her drink.
Man,
oh,
hey,
man, what's wrong with y'all?
I'm sorry to mention the field,
Hey, what's going down, man?
Man, you off? You don't ditch that broad.
What's going on, guys? Hey, and where's my money?
Man, will you shut up?
Okay. You can't tell me what to do.
All right, then.
Please.
Let your husband do it.
Ooh, my husband?
Her husband?
He's in town. He knows. And he's looking for you right now.
You know, it's been cool.
What?
Hanging with you.
What?
You know everything. All right, bye.
What? Oh, no, you don't. You got me into this mess, Darren, and you're going to help me get out of it.
But look, it doesn't make any sense for him to catch us together. Now, does it?
Man, that's right. He can't prove nothing. It's your word against his.
What if he asks his mother where I've been? She thinks I've been with my family cousin.
Oh, well, tell her you went to go stay with a friend while her husband was in the hospital.
What friend? Huh?
I'll get, what's her name? Crystal testified.
Yeah, I don't know her. Yeah.
Doesn't matter. Bye.
Okay.
Leave. Sayonara.
Okay,
Hoop scoop. Go.
All right. All right. I'm gone. I'm leaving.
Women, man.
Chill out.
Gone. I'm... Darren.
What?
I love you.
Come
on, man.
Not cool. Bye. Go.
Get out of here.
He don't love you. Dang. Now, somebody tell me, how did the prophet find out? Because he's not supposed to be home before tomorrow.
Man, it couldn't have been but one person.
Who?
Man, guess.
Look, man, I don't know.
Man, who else you know that want to get back at you for something that
man,
you did
just
today?
Tell him. Look, man, I got time for games.
Man, you put him out for that broad.
You mean Chip? Man, I'm going to break his sanctified neck.
No, man, I wouldn't do that if I were you.
And why not? I've whipped it before, but this time, ooh, I'm a killer.
That's not what I'm saying. He has this bodyguard that follows him wherever he goes.
Man, that's what I'm here for.
What bodyguard?
You guys remember when I used to beat up on Crystal, right?
So?
Well, one time, I thought I could knock some sense into her. So I was prepared to give her the slapping of her life. Yeah. Do you know she said something like, Satan, I rebuke you.
Oh, my God.
I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Didn't know something knocked me down and I couldn't get up for 10 whole minutes?
Man, what the folks do to you?
Man, what was it?
I was scared to ask her. So I asked Chip.
Great idea.
And he said the Lord protects his children and they have a guardian angel that does that at all costs.
Look, I don't care if he has 100 angels protecting him. I'm still gonna break his neck.
Okay. But don't say I didn't warn you.
Nah, man. Let's get out of here before Mike cracks off for real.
I'm all right.
No, you aren't.
I wish I was crazy.
Man, you are crazy.
I know what you're calling me. Bro, wait. Why are we even drinking here? Let's go somewhere else.
Nah, man, look. We always do our drinking right here. And get lost. Got me tripping.
Maybe I am crazy. Oh, man.
Hey! Have you seen a man named Darren?
No. What does he look like?
Like a snake in the grass with yellow streaks running down his back.
I wish I could help,
But there are just too many people that fit that description here.
Okay, then. You need to tell me I can find Brady's boys in.
Actually, I'm heading there right now. Come on, man, I'll show you.
I'll stop right there. I heard it was in this direction.
Well, whoever told you that was lying, my friend. Come on, man, I'll show you.
Come on, Miss Sweeney, let's hurry. It's almost 12 o'clock. I don't want to miss my stories.
I think we got it straightened out this time, Miss Marshall. Don't even worry about it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, where are they?
I never know where.
Ladies, I see you back. Is there anything I can do to help you out?
No, thank you. You can just tell Miss Hazel that we're here.
Okay, certainly will.
Hello, ladies. Chip. Now, if she doesn't accept our offer, there's just nothing else we can do.
Well, I just hope she hurries up.
Now, which story is it that you was watching?
You know, the one, the old and the restful.
Oh, you know what? I heard that was a good one. It's crazy yes, what they put on TV these days.
Yes, it is. It is good.
Well, ladies, what's the verdict?
Well, we talked it over with the chairman of the board, and he decided you were right.
Yes, I knew they see it my way.
But there is one stipulation.
And what's that?
You are going to be the one to tell him to get out.
Me? Well, I think that's a man's job.
Oh, well, then get your husband to do it.
Walter will never consent to that.
Now, Hazel, you know we love you over at Belle Queen, right? Now, we need you to show us just how much you love us, okay? Let's go, Miss Sweeney.
All right.
I've not been to miss too much of my stories. Whew. This is the final episode.
Look, honey, don't cry. I overheard the whole thing. Now, don't you see what me and Elder Brian have been trying to tell you? Now, if they were really children of God, they wouldn't have the heart to do such a thing.
Shut up, Walter! You and Elder Brian are the cause of all of this. If you love me, Walter, you quit that church and I'd have my friends.
Look, look, Jesus is first in my life. Now, I love you very much, but why don't you let him be the same to you?
You won't quit that church?
Look, the church has nothing to do with it. I have Jesus in my heart, and I can't quit him.
Well, you don't love me, Walter, and I hate you. I hate your church,
look,
and I hate your preacher. Don't talk to me.
Look, listen, listen, listen.
What's wrong with Hazel, Walter?
Just need Jesus, that's all.
Yeah. Well, she seems awfully upset.
Well, I think they want to put out a Belle Queen because I've been born again.
Well, the devil is busy.
Yeah, you got that right.
Man, he'll do anything to stop the word of God.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Darren!
What?
Nora's husband was just here.
Where is he now?
I took him on a wild goose chase, and I doubled back here. But I know he's coming, and when he finds out that I tricked him.
All right.
Will, Jeff, let's go! Man, what's going on?
The prophet's still out here lurking. Y'all gotta hide him.
Man, there go that fool Chip. Man, let's get him now.
Hey, what's the big idea?
I just thought you opened up your mouth about me and Nora.
Man, I don't know what
he's
talking about.
Hey, why you guys want to start trouble?
Started. He's the one that started when he opened his big mouth, and I'm finna close it.
Hey, man, we ain't got time for that, bro. We gotta hide you.
Yeah, man. But once this fool's right, we gotta get you in. And we can get him later.
He's coming.
Man, come on. Man, let's go.
Hey!
Hey! Hey, I see you right there.
Man,
hey.
Oh, snap. There he goes.
I'll get you later, Chip.
Jesus, Jesus,
what
Jesus.
What's that all about?
Jesus. I don't know. I'm gonna ask you.
Jesus.
Crystal.
Crystal. Oh, Jesus.
Crystal, are you okay?
Yes. Okay.
Y'all off work early, aren't you?
Off permanently, you mean? I just got fired.
Really? Why'd they fire you?
Somebody dug up my past, and out the back door I went.
Hey, well, don't feel bad. Rejoice. What does 1 Peter 4:12 and 13 say? Beloved, do not be surprised by the fiery ordeal which comes upon you to prove you, as if some strange thing were happening to you.
But rejoice, insomuch that you are sharing in Christ's sufferings. Also rejoice and be glad when his glory is revealed.
it really doesn't matter because I know that God cares for me. Right. Look at me. Look at me. I was a worthless nothing. I felt worthless, tired, and unhappy. But God, He came into my life and He gave me a peace that I cannot explain. He saved my soul from death, hell, and destruction. You know, all these material things, they will pass away. But what I have now is eternal. Lord, I am your child, and the ways of the world are no longer a part of me.
Look at me. I was the one that was lost. I thought when I got all my degrees, all the money I needed, position, status, women and things, I would have it made. But after I got it, I was still searching for something. I was lonely and I worried about things. I started a little hustle on the side just to keep up. And before I knew it, I was caught up. I was hooked and in trouble. Then God, He stepped into my life and made me a new person.
You know, God really does care for us, and He's coming back real soon.
You know what, Crystal, you're right. What does it say in the Word? For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first.
All right, you know I'm new with this. Then the alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet them in the clouds, to be with the Lord in the air. And so shall we all be with the Lord forever.
Right. It also says, wherefore, we should comfort one another with these words.
Man, church's been out for an hour and a half. What's taking him so long to come out?
Man, maybe he knows we're out here waiting for him.
And how is he gonna know that? Because the only people that know about our plans are us and Miss Hazel.
But I can't help but wonder why she wants us to burn the church down, though.
Quite frankly, I don't care. But if Chip don't come out, we can kill two birds with one stone.
Hey, look, man. Burning down that stupid church and beating up that bum Chip, that's one thing. But I ain't about to kill nobody.
Dude, chill. We're not really gonna kill anybody.
Although you might get killed yourself when you know who catches up with you.
Look, man, I'm mad enough as it is. Don't make me add another name to the list.
Hey, look, I don't like the way you two are talking. Man, count me out.
Man, if you don't sit down and shut up.
Look, man, how's the church gonna burn down anyway? Look at this fog, man. It's gonna storm.
Just because you see fog doesn't mean it's gonna storm. The sky is clear.
Man, I know you seen that lightning about 10 minutes ago.
That's probably some electrical explosion or a transformer blowing up.
Man, whatever.
Hey, y'all tripping, man.
Look, but what Mike said is really starting to get to me, man. This neighborhood's creeping me out.
So you wanna go home, be a little punk, cry in the corner?
You know what? Yeah, D, I'm done. I don't need you bums.
All right, but before you go, go inside the church and make Chip come out.
Ain't gonna happen, Chip.
Go inside the church and make Chip come out.
I ain't gonna do it.
Hey, man, you wanna go home, don't you?
Yeah.
Man, then get moving.
Don't touch me, man.
Hurry up.
Chip. Hey, man, ain't nobody in there.
What?
What you mean ain't nobody in there? We boarded up the back doors.
Man, the windows are boarded up, too.
I ain't seen nobody come out. Oh, well, burn down anyway.
Man, it's not gonna happen.
No! Burn it down!
No, man. What's that noise?
No! No! No!
Hazel?
He's gone!
Hazel, sit up or you get us all caught.
Man, who's gone?
Walter's gone. We were lying in bed together. And then all of a sudden there was this light, and I screamed and I reached for him, and he's gone.
Are you sure he was in bed with you at the time?
Yes, I'm sure. Right. I had just apologized to him for being so nasty this morning.
Man, it was something about that flesh, man. That flesh we saw.
Elder Rogers, go see if he's home. Go see.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Elder Brian! Elder Brian!
Man, hurry up!
Chill, man. All right.
Man, ain't nobody in there.
What?
No.
My son took his key out and go inside earlier.
Man, I just told you, ain't nobody in there.
Chip, see if Chip is home. Well, don't just stand there. See if Chip is home.
He's gone too.
He's gone too.
He's gone too.
I just don't know what's going on, man.
Hazel! Hazel! Hazel, we heard you screaming, honey. What's wrong? Listen, if we did or we said anything, sugar, we're so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Do me a favor.
Oh, anything.
See if Crystal's home.
Okay, I'll be right back. Okay. Crystal?
Hey, hey, maybe you can tell us what's going on.
Yeah, man, because everybody disappeared.
Yeah, I know. I just heard about it on the news. People are disappearing all over the world. Both the dead and the live ones.
What?
I mean, it's true. The entire world is in hysterics.
Oh. She's not there. She's gone.
She's gone?
Reverend, what is going on?
I can think of only one explanation. Do you remember the revival 2 weeks ago? Well, now there was something that Elder Rogers said that stuck out with me. So I went home and looked it up in my Bible, and I studied it, and I thought I'd have enough time to come and tell you about what I found, but... Oh, now I see it's just too late.
What was it?
The rapture.
Oh. No.
It said that the Lord God will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the archangel's call and the sound of the trumpet of God. The dead in Christ shall rise first, then those who remain will be caught up to meet him in the air, and oh, they will be with the Lord Jesus always.
So you mean they go to heaven?
But wait, they could have, because you see, we're still here, and the Reverend's still here.
Yeah.
I couldn't go.
What you mean?
The Lord was calling for true holiness.
True holiness? So, Reverend, you would deceive us?
Yeah, Reverend, not once have you ever said, talked, or spoke about living holy before.
But Elder Brian did.
Well, I'm sorry.
Of course.
But wait now. Oh, there's no excuse. You can't blame me for your sin.
So, what's gonna happen to us?
Lord, oh, please forgive me.
Did I get left?
Man, go.
Did we get left?
Man.
This ain't happening.
Reverend,
don't talk to me.
No. What's
gonna happen to us?
Oh, God.
Walter. Where are you, Walter? Walter, I'm sorry. Forgive me, Walter. I don't know what to do. He's in the church. Walter, are you in here? Walter. Oh. He's working late. Walter. Oh. I don't want to burn. Lord, please spare us.
And he said to me, do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this book, for the time is near. Let the evildoer still do evil, and the filthy still be filthy, and the righteous still do right, and the holy still be holy. Behold, I am coming soon, bringing my recompense to repay everyone for what he has done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end.